It was the teams from down south that were dominant over the weekend. The Tasmanian sides, Northwest Tasmania Thunder, as well as the Hobart Chargers. Got here Rohan Short to go over that. They were pretty impressive, weren't they?
Yeah, some interesting results from the weekend from the Tasmanian teams. They stamped their authority on the competition coming over to the mainland and dominating in the way that they did.
BJ Jenkins, End One Player of the Week. 31 points and 36 points in these consecutive games. This is probably one of the imports we should be keeping an eye on, I feel.
Yeah, look, his D-League experience in the NBA, whilst he only averaged 9 or so points in the D-League while he was there, he had a spate in 2011 where he went on for about 13, 14 games in double figures. He's a point guard, he's stocky, he's aggressive. He's going to be a lot to handle for a lot of the guards in this competition. You know, from Murray State, a good school, good pedigree, I think he's going to be a really difficult guy to handle. And just from all reports of that Knox game, you know, very much a pivotal leader for the Northwest Tasmanian team, exactly what they were missing last year.
Were there any shocks you felt that from the results over the weekend?
Look, you know, not really. Maybe Kilsyth giving Sandringham a little bit of a touch-up. It wasn't necessarily a surprise. It was probably more the margin and the lack of point production from some of the teams. And if we look at all the new coaches in the league this weekend just passed, they only went 3 of 8. So Rod Pop obviously getting a win and the two wins for Hobart. Now, you know, there's some teams here that need to get themselves organised early on with thin rosters. So some big tests. Maybe Hobart's two wins is surprising to us, given the fact we haven't seen a lot of them in the pre-season. But, you know, look, I'm pretty much not surprised. I think most tipsters would have got most of them right.
Northwest Tasmania Nunawading, certainly a game to look forward to this weekend. Is there any others that have caught your eye?
Obviously, the Spectres with the double, like you say, this weekend is a big test for them. You know, Northwest Tasmania obviously being the team to watch, given their little touch-up of teams over the course of the weekend. But, you know, the Centre of Excellence is a team that's going to surprise, hopefully. You know, they can get their stuff together. And an undermanned Mount Gambier and Albury could be a team that they could snatch to get their first win. But, you know, obviously Dandenong, Geelong, but the team for everyone to get at the game for everyone in Melbourne anyway to get out and watch this week is Knox versus Kilsyth.
The rivalry.
The massive rivalry that we have. So I'm excited and I'll be getting down to that one.
Thanks for your time, Rohan, and hopefully there's some good results and good point production from the imports going into round 2.